Don't be a stranger. Was in the early springtime when the grass was showing green. I met a girl in Hartville on her way to Silver Springs. With bright blue eyes that sparkled and long, soft golden hair, she told me of her father and the ranch he had out there. I told her I was headed for a job some ways from her, out east of Rawhide Mountain, punching cows for the single spur. Her sky blue eyes, they sparkled as she tossed her hair and smiled, then touched my arm and murmured in a voice so sweet and mild, "Darling, don't be a stranger when time is on your hands. You're just one range over in a large and lonesome land. It takes a bit of courage if you're a worthy man, so don't be a stranger. Come and see me when you can." I worked those cows on Roundup, finished up by mid-July, then turned my pony westward to the girl with bright blue eyes. Well, the summer sky, it sparkled, and the meadowlark sang true, the lupin and the larkspur and the flax all shining blue. While crossing Rawhide Mountain on the ridges up on high, I heard the wind a-whisperin' with a murmur and a sigh. The night grew dark and lonely as I heard the night bird sing and recalled the voice so tender of the girl from Silver Springs. "Darlin', don't be a stranger when time is on your hands. You're just one range over in a large and lonesome land. It takes a bit of courage if you're a worthy man, so don't be a stranger. Come and see me when you can." On down the slope of Rawhide, after riding 2 days straight, I found the trail I needed, and I tied up at her gate. She seemed surprised to see me as a dark cloud crossed her face. Then her smile came back like sunshine, and she spoke with easy grace. She said she'd gotten married and was headed farther west. It'd been so nice to know me, and she wished me all the best. As I stepped into the saddle and rode back to the single spur, her early words still echoed, and my mind was in a blur. "Darlin', don't be a stranger when time is on your hands. You're just one range over in a large and lonesome land. It takes a bit of courage if you're a worthy man, so don't be a stranger. Come and see me when you can." Now I ride the lonesome canyons and the grasslands of this range. It gives me time to ponder those ways that seem so strange. I ride my horse in twilight as the mournful night owl sings, and his voice recalls the soft words of the girl from Silver Springs. I can't forget the sweetness as her words run through my head, and I think that at the moment she had meant what she had said. Her words, though false they've proven, have a calm effect on me, for they help me see quite clearly what was never meant to be. "Darlin', don't be a stranger when time is on your hands. You're just one range over in a large and lonesome land. It takes a bit of courage if you're a worthy man, so don't be a stranger. Come and see me when you can."